Hey everybody, it's me, Wildman Beats here, and this is going to be episode 16 of Code Vein. And last episode, we got to what I think is the end of the Blood Cathedral. I feel like there's a boss room coming next. Don't know what to expect for it, but hopefully it's going to be another blast, because we've been blasting through all of these bosses. First try on, like, the last two, maybe three? I don't know, pretty close to it, but don't want to go in with too much confidence, but hopefully we can do it. So, anyway, thank you for coming to watch this video. I hope you enjoy, and otherwise, let's get into it. All right, we got the hammer. Boom, bagoosh. Now, I do want to note that I don't feel confident going into this. I think part of the reason I've done so well against the last couple bosses is because we just kind of run into them in the middle of doing stuff, right? I haven't had a warm-up for this one. I don't have my controls down. I'm not in the zone. I think it's going to take a death first. Let's level up, though. We got 37 thou haze. Like 20 thou. Yeah, there. This is a boss for sure, dude. Uh-oh. Already procced a cutscene. Oh. What? Why is she here?
You? No, it's someone else.
What do you mean it's someone else?
Memory is what binds the very essence of oneself together.
Leda.
If you gather broken fragments of blood code, you can stitch them together with threads of memory. Please, I beg of you, I beseech you, use your power now.
This is weird. Huh? You gotta unscrew the thing first. Or not? Isis Vestige Part D? That's it? Okay, that wasn't the cutscene for whatever boss we're about to run into. Or is that something I have to use? I think we still go forward to the boss. I was gonna say something before that cutscene proc. Can't remember what it is now, though. Oh well. Should I talk to you first?
I've been waiting.
Restore vestige.
Please, spin a thread of memory for me.
Oh hey, we can do these here. Okay. These are all Isis vestiges. I'm not gonna do it here though. Let's just go. Ominous power from the other side. Fuck it, dude. I'm ready. They're really making this feel like a special moment, though.
That didn't do a thing.
Uh-oh, it's... Okay, never mind. It was cracked at the beginning. I thought it was cracking open.
This way.
Oh, they have like a connection. They both have to do it to make it open. Where's the boss?
Come on.
What is it? Ugh. Golden toads.
What the?
Is that the guardian of this place?
It's a wolf with human limbs.
Looks like we've still got a ways to go.
We're going through.
Alright. This thing looks so whack.
Bring it anytime.
What the fuck? I need to call him. That was what you were supposed to do.
Oh shit!
Oh. Oh, that's not good. How do I avoid that shit? I'm not completely sure of what's going on. Hey, look at his HP bar, it's dead. That was easy as fuck. This hammer hits hard though, to be fair. First try again. Gee, I don't know.
It looks like the body is still lingering here. Or maybe something in this place is keeping it here.
Huh? Oh shit, it's a two-part boss, is that what they're saying? Maybe not.
A vestige? But look at the size of it. Hold it. Something's not right.
Oh, it is a two-part boss. It's coming back to life.
What in the world? It regenerated so quickly.
Is that vestige controlling the regeneration somehow? That's it. We have to destroy
it. So we have to attack the vestige thing. Ugh. Okay, so I gotta find where the vestige is in the boss fight room. Oh! What? Bruh. What am I supposed to do about that? What? Where's the vestige? I'm out of heals. It's go time. Oh shit! What the fuck is going on, dude? Okay, we didn't kill it first try. This is a whack boss, though. I don't know. That fire stuff, you don't live by hiding behind the column. Let's try it again. There you are, you weird ass dog.
Bring it anytime.
I don't understand. I took my whole HP pool there. And I'm still dying. I can't move. I can't move. This is ridiculous. You know, I'm just not gonna go for my haze. I don't think 17,000's it's a decent amount, but it's not. I don't care too much. I'd rather just try different things in the fight rather than going straight for my lost haze first thing. Never mind, I can't help myself. Maybe you just gotta sprint in. like that. That didn't feel any good. Okay, so once you get too close.
Bring it any time.
Okay, maybe I can hide for this one. Perfect. Fuck. I need to get out of the lightning, but it's everywhere. Heal. Heal again. Oh, he's charging up the explosion. Yep. Okay, this is a chance to heal. This one does. Oh! Never mind. No. Heal me. Thanks. Yukumo's dead. Hey, on the ground. That's not good, or is it? Oh! Die, die. Oh my God, I killed it with 19 HP. Holy shit. That was so close. I think I understood how to beat it in case I died again, though, so. To be fair.
That is hard.
Nope. Not even a scratch.
What's the plan? It'll regenerate soon.
I have to touch it.
It's about to.
Grab that thing. That's where your power is. You deplete the vestige.
If you gather broken fragments of blood code, you can stitch them together with threads of memory. It's all right. You can do it.
We'll see.
Please, save everyone.
Cruz? Whoa.
No!
Uh-oh. That's the first time my characters made sound. That's interesting. That's the first time that they've made any noise the whole game. I think. Huh. Looks like we're still in the Blood Cathedral somehow. So maybe we've been here before?
We will divide the body of the queen into relics. Which we will then seal into the successors. This will keep them separate and safe.
Oh, so that was part of the queen, because that was the successor of the ribcage. So that must have been the queen's ribcage we just fought. Which seems bizarre. Why would it end up being a wolf thing with legs? Okay, what's this?
Are you insane? Just shove that devil into a blast furnace already.
That's it. Yeah, why would they separate the body and the parts? That seems strange.
We've already attempted that.
But that doesn't mean...
Oh, the body's too strong to be burned or destroyed or anything? Whack. Hey, where's the next scene thing? Don't make me walk down the stairs too long.
You'd have to stay in a crypt forever. Are you sure you're willing to do that?
You have. So they put people with parts of the queen in different places where they're stuck in a crypt forever? And then the body parts of the queen probably somehow possessed them and turned them into monsters, right?
I have no interest in living a false life. Whatever the torment, I can bear it. If it means helping her, then I must.
Who is Aurora and Jack anyway? Wait, Jack? No, I don't recognize it. I thought I did for a second, but no. Unless I did. In which case, I'm just a genius. We're almost to the bottom.
I am prepared, and I shall remain ever at the ready. As long as there are still people who I would die to defend. So please, rest easy, Karen.
Karen?
I will be at your side for now and always.
Who's Karen? What? And now we're at the doors. Is that Aurora? Or is that Karen? What about Cruz?
Wait. I'll be honest. I never expected to see you again like this.
This is real, not a memory?
It's been a long time, Louis.
Aurora? Aurora, is that you? What are you doing here?
The answer was inside that memory. Fragments of the Queen's body were locked inside of successors. Human sacrifices.
Oh.
And I am one of them.
The Queen? But she was put down years ago.
Officially, yes. But there's more to that, as you probably know. Revenants are seemingly immortal creatures, locked in a cycle of death and rebirth.
So is the Queen.
But if you destroy a Revenant's heart, then their body dissolves, and they can never revive again. The Queen should have been no exception.
Did the Queen not have a heart?
An immortal among immortals, even when reduced to ash. The Queen's regeneration couldn't be stopped.
So you locked her away?
Yes. By carving her undying body into relics, and fusing those relics into the bodies of others.
Ugh.
In doing so, the Queen's menace faded, and for a brief time there was peace. But we all knew the plan was desperate and flawed. Even with the relics locked away, the Queen's desire to live on could not be suppressed. The relics soon began to corrode the bodies of the successors, causing them constant and terrible anguish. You have witnessed the end result. They are reduced to living as beasts, devoid of all reason, seeking only to act on their most basic instincts.
And they regenerate quick. What about you?
Yet, it was your power that restored my sanity.
Oh, she was that thing.
You had the ability to accept the Queen's blood.
What?
Huh?
You have the power to quell the relics at last. Please, I beg you, relieve them of their suffering. This gate leads to the crypts where the successors rest. To reach the others, you will need to find these gates.
I saw those.
I believe you can open it now.
I wonder why.
I will remain here, as I always have, to watch over and protect the paths leading to the successors.
and the blood bead flow.
So, this really is the source.
Yes, beyond the gate. There rests the one who sheds tears of blood.
Oh. Is that what they are?
Take care of her, Louis.
Her? What do you mean?
Cruz? Oh, shit. Wait, what?
If the resting successors join the ranks of the lost, then the seals will break. The relics will be released, and the queen will be reborn. Before that happens...
Of course they have to have her freeze before she can say the most important thing. Restore memory?
This is...
I didn't just restart the whole thing, did I? Oh, no, definitely not. That was whack.
So then, it appears that fate has seen fit to revive me one more time.
Oh, she didn't die. She'll just keep
Are
this form.
Are you really all right?
Yes. I'm fine, actually. The relic is sleeping soundly now. And you? I take it you're the one who gave me back my lost heart?
I'm sorry.
No, Louis. It's all right. If anyone should be apologizing, it's me. I've forced all of the burden onto you. Please, Louis, I'm asking you one more time. Go and visit the person who lies beyond the gate.
The source of the blood.
Sorry, I need to sleep for a while. Since I felt this drowsy.
Is that bad? Kind of get the idea that I was supposed to be happy, but I couldn't completely tell. And we got the Isis blood code. Specializes in ranged combat by overpowering enemies. Oh, with various I-core attacks. You know, I tried out the ranged. It was kind of cool, but I didn't like that it didn't feel like long range. It just felt ranged, which... I like to hit hard, and that's what this thing does. So I can open these now, huh? Oh, definitely can. Imagine going downstairs the normal way. Oh. Whoa, that's a lot of blood beads. Holy moly. Oh, no shortage from now on. We can't let them know.
So it's true. It was you all along. Karen.
Karen.
What in the world is all this?
I don't know if that dress is safe for work.
All of this is a part of her?
It's her body?
It never ended. The Queen was still alive, and we were kept alive all this time because of the blood that flowed from this place. My sister became a successor. She sacrificed herself to stop the Queen, and her tears are what kept us alive.
Louis.
Let's just give him a minute.
Sorry for losing my composure. I'm okay now.
So, what's our next step?
Finding the successors.
Are we just gonna leave your sister?
There aren't any signs of frenzy at the moment.
Oh.
Now we know that the lack of blood beads is only a part of the ongoing calamity that was started by the Queen. I want to find a way to end this disaster once and for all. It is a duty that I must see through to the very end.
Shouldn't that be we?
Yakumo.
If a friend is struggling, if they're giving their all trying to push their way forward, well then I've got their back. That's just how it works.
Hey, I said I was glad to do whatever you needed me to, didn't I?
Guys.
Don't look at me like that.
That power of yours, it's the only hope we have right now. I'm glad you're here. Let's find the successors before the Queen is resurrected. Karen, we'll be back for you. Just hold on.
So Karen's turning into the frenzy that her sister, the Queen, was. And Aurora was their mother or something? Or Louis's mother? I'm just trying to piece together what's actually happening. Okay, and what do we have here? Pure blood. Grants Ichor. Causes body to regenerate. Whatever. I don't need that. Interesting. Now, the only problem I see with this is, okay, so if she's gonna end up frenzying like her sister, and right now she's producing blood beads, if we find a way to stop it and kill her, destroy her, whatever, stop the process, won't that also stop the flow of blood beads then, and in the process kill all revenants since they no longer have blood bead source? Hey, I can see a person through the wall right there. Maybe that's all the way upstairs though. Yeah, I think that might be Aurora. She awake now? Oh, Jesus Christ! This dude.
The hunter.
Who's he trying to get?
You.
Oh, it's Jack.
I destroyed you with my own hands. How are you here now?
Is that supposed to do something?
Just as I suspected. They have the power to calm the relics. It's just like Eva's. No, it's even stronger than hers. You know, you could join with us, Carrier of the Blood. That power of yours, it would be a shame to waste such a resource.
Careful. He's stronger than he looks. We'll do our best to shield you. Just remember to protect your heart.
Very well. In that case.
There's a heap of things I want to know. And you will tell me. I'll make you tell me.
Whoa, what's going on here? Dang, he got the parry. The hammer. How about they attack him all at once instead of one at a time? Who's behind him? Who the fuck?
Why are you here?
To keep you from going too far.
Why are her boobs like bursting out of her dress?
Fine, that's enough. I'll leave for now. But remember, I'll be coming back for you. Give my offer some thought, hmm?
He's leaving that lady behind? Oh, no. Oh, he was saying that to me. So that guy tore apart my body? And I guess when I killed the queen, like we saw in my memories, she got the stab on me. So I guess she put queen's blood in me. I've got 40 thou. Let's take a look at Isis. Surge of electricity. Fires three powerful bolts of lightning at your target's feet. Lightning bullets. Stake that pierces the target. Reduces maximum HP to increase the amount of ichor that can be held. A lot of electricity stuff. I don't know how much I care about that, but I guess if there were a boss that's vulnerable to electricity, then that's good. Only problem I see with that is none of these bosses tell you what their weaknesses are. So, you know, I guess the point of that is like, oh, experiment, try different things and see what does more damage. But man, I don't have enough time to be focusing on, oh, that did 350, that one did 370 damage, you know? It's like, I'm busy fighting the thing, all right? So I don't think I'm gonna ever be able to really utilize that idea of damage types and vulnerabilities very well. Because I'm not good enough to the point where I can fight the thing and focus on what's getting more damage numbers at the same time. But that being said, Boy, we've done a lot in this episode, lore-wise, and killed the boss. Second try. I think that's still pretty good. But that's where we're going to leave it for episode 16 of Code Vein. So thank you for subscribing and hitting that bell button. And as always, have a great day.